Hey, John from Shine On here, and today we've got a super awesome update and brand new type of product that we are bringing to you, and I'm super excited to get into not only what it is, but how to make it. So let's get started. First off, this is a buyer upload message card product. Now that might sound a little bit confusing, but once I explain it, it'll make complete sense. As you know, we have buyer upload graphic products. We have our circles, we have our hearts, and we have our dog tags. Now, what this new product is it's that same buyer upload jewelry piece. It's just now the way we're packaging it is we're sliding a message card in behind it. This is gonna allow you for all sorts of new marketing methods and ways to really sell these items and attach an emotional piece to it. Now customers have more ways to not only put a picture there and put an engraving on the back, but now that personalized message that can go right behind it can really help to sell that jewelry item and create that emotional like touch. So let's go ahead and jump right over and take a look at our first one, our graphic circle, and see how it's built and how you work with it so you guys can get out there and start selling it. All right. So let's go first into the platform here where we can look at how this works on the Shine On platform. First thing, when you come in, you're going to come to the dashboard. Obviously, that's not what we want to look at. Let's go create our first product. So the first one I'm going to show you is our buyer upload circle. So let's look here. Let's search for this. And we will see right here, you're going to see a buyer upload luxury circle necklace with a POD message card. So this is a message card with the buyer upload graphic piece on there. So let's go ahead and go in here and create the product. It's looking good. So as you can see, the first step is you actually need to upload your message card. So obviously take into effect that there's gonna be a circle right in the middle when you create your message card. I'm going to look back here. I've got a Mother's Day one that we'll throw in there because I think this would be an amazing product for Mother's Day. Let's obviously for Christmas, but I'm thinking ahead. So let's just start here. We're gonna put in this Mother's Day message card, and let's go ahead and look at what the next steps are. So we've created that. We've put our message card in, and now as you can see, I'm gonna need to go back and play with my message card design because the way this is laying, it doesn't work. And that's something that you're gonna have to do. A lot of your existing message cards you might have to rework them so that they fit with these larger pieces of jewelry that are going in there. So just think about that when you're building your product. Obviously, there's a silver version and there's a gold version down here. Okay, we're gonna put in our title, obviously. You've got your cost for the silver, you've got your cost for the gold. Don't forget, you also get an engraving upsell on this one, which is great. The average order value on these products is gonna be top-notch. We selected a niche for our product, and we are going to publish that. And we got to give it a minute, and then pretty soon we will be able to actually go in here and see what this product looks like. All right, so our product has now been created and it is in our product list here. So the first step is I want to take you to look at the product page so you can see what it looks like, what your customer's going through, so you can understand the full experience from when we go back to start customizing it. So what it actually looks like on the Shine On page is this. You're gonna see add your photo with a nice arrow. You're gonna see a really nice rendering of your message card, the product laid on there with an example image in there. Now, that example image is not doing much except inspiring them. So it needs to match your niche because the goal of this page, if you notice, is there's not a lot of other things distracting your buyer away from doing the one step we want them to do, which is upload your photo. Once they've uploaded that photo and we're now showing them their photo, we've built this emotional attachment to help them go and purchase. So we try not to distract too much here. But like I said, the one thing that you're gonna really wanna look to do is customize this image that's showing up right here. Because if this is Mother's Day and you're showing a couple, maybe not the best idea. So we'll get into that later, but just so you understand, the whole point of this page is they can look at gold and they can look at silver and they can upload a photo. It's all we want them to do. So when you go in to upload your photo, it's gonna pull up a window here, and then we'll scroll down, we'll find a picture like this. We'll zoom out a bit, drag it in so it looks really nice like that, and we're gonna confirm the design. So now that we've confirmed the design, we're dropped on the buying page, if you wanna call it. And this is where you see a really nice rendering of not only the message card, but your buyer's photo. This is where that emotional attachment is gonna help them to get to that add to cart stage, which is why we don't get in their way in the beginning, because once they've added that photo, you got them. You know, there's a high likelihood they're gonna convert. So that's why we focus on that, and then we bring them to this stage rather than asking them to buy first and customize after. We do customize first, we gotcha, now go buy. So again, you land here and we've got choice between stainless and gold. It is now showing some other images because you've uploaded an image. So now we can show you some different images that you can look at, and you can customize what your buyer sees after this point. And then you have the ability to add text here. And again, remember, engraving upsell. When they add this engraving in, it's charging them extra. If I get rid of this engraving, the price drops. So remember that. If we can get them to add that engraving, that's an extra $10. You guys make an extra, I don't remember directly off the top of my head, but a couple dollars just on them adding that in. So it's a really nice little upsell that we do. And then we can simply add to cart from there. There's also a change image button back here in case you missed that, so they can go back and actually change the image once they've uploaded it. Also in this upload process, it also works really good on mobile, I should say. We just relaunched on the platform our new mobile buyer upload process to help with remakes and everything else, but also to provide a better experience so that we can make this work better for your buyers. If they don't like the image that they're seeing, there is a change image button right here where you can instantly go in this process and find a different photo if you wanted to. But anyway, that's what it looks like. That's the process. So now let's go in and do some more customization to this product. So in here in the back end, you've got your normal things of quantity selector, coupons, making sure your audience and remarketing and all of that is set up correctly. You've got your variants down here where we can play with our pricing on them if you want to do that at this point. The big thing I want to take you in here is and talk about is the images. So you can see there's these two images, and those are our sample images with the couple in them. And what you're going to want to do if, like, let's say you're going for To My Mom, right? So maybe you're going to put a picture of you on there. So like I'm buying this for my mom. She's not going to want a picture of herself on there. She's going to want a picture of me. Let me take that back. She's going to want a picture of my daughter on there. She doesn't care about me anymore. She only cares about my daughter. That's how it works when you have kids. So I would want to put a picture of my daughter on this to give to my mom. So if I'm selling that product, the couple's probably not helping you much. So what you're gonna wanna do is actually put an image of a little girl in there. So you can come in here and you can download these PSDs. And in these PSDs, you're gonna be able to go in and change that photo. And when you change that photo, like I said, change it to a little girl, and then you can come up here and you can, you know, put in, you can load or upload your photos to match your niche. Now you'll have your instructional photos on the beginning, and then you'll have your images on the back end. So this is probably, I feel like I'm, you know, you guys might have just heard me say this, but it's super important that you design these instructional images to match what your customer is actually doing, so that you can push them through to that next step. Like I said, if you can get them to upload their photo, you're gonna get them. So that's the main thing, is this is like the one real big thing that you can control on that first step. So you really need to take it serious and make sure you're providing them a really good image that matches what they're gonna do, and even inspire them. Like I said, if you're selling to moms, putting a picture of a daughter or like a granddaughter or to a grandma, or inspire them. Maybe it's a picture of someone graduating, and so it's like they've reached a big milestone in their life, so they're showing their mom like, hey, look, you got me. Think about it, and, you know, inspire, and then match your niche and your targeting that you're doing, because that's what's gonna make this product the most successful. So those are really the big things when it comes to customizing this product. We already know that we have had great success with these hearts, circles, and the dog tags, and we fully expect this to even be better because now we're putting this message card aspect behind it. It's gonna be really killer. Now, at the time that this video is coming out, it is just the circles that are released, but we are planning within a week or so of this launch to launch both the hearts and the dog tags as well, so be on the lookout for that. But that's the end of this. That is how to get set up. We'll do some more instructional videos later and really get into the dirty of like how to play with this artwork template and change it in a couple different softwares and all of that. So look for those videos to be released really soon. But that's it for the day. Have fun. Good luck selling.